Hi guys, it's Gav here from DartsPlanet.tv. Thanks for joining me. In today's video, I've got Jack Main with me. Thank you for joining me.
Not a problem.
Another one who is sponsored by Jess and JBD Sports Agents and practice a lot with Darren Webster.
I do, yeah.
How has that helped you with the game?
No, and helped me massively from when I first started playing and then practicing with him. Like I say, come on, leaps and bounds, learn how to count.
That's my problem counting. That is my problem counting, even now.
Same as. But
is it?
No, it's come on no end since I've been with Darren. So can't thank him enough. And obviously Jess for what he's done.
Yeah.
And supporting me along the way. So
yeah, they're a great company, aren't they?
Yeah, unreal. Like I say, can't appreciate him any more than I can really. Like I say, I've seen my progress go from one level to another since been with them both. So
yeah.
As I say, can't help them enough. Well, thank them enough, sorry. So
you play on the Challenge Tour and the Development Tour, don't you?
I do, yeah.
So you keep really busy on both them. How are they both going this year?
Yeah, really well. On the Development Tour, doing really well. Sitting in the top 20. And Challenge Tour, I'm just getting to grips with it. It's a little bit different, but
there's some quality players.
Yeah, the field's unreal. Well, both fields are unreal. The talent on either tour, you can't fault it.
Yeah.
Then you have to think about the next step as well, which you're thinking about what you're playing against now. It's only going to get 10 times harder. So,
have you got goals for the future? Like, are you looking at a year ahead or goals, or are you just doing it month by month?
Yeah, you have obviously baby steps and you have the end goal, what you want. Just take it as it comes, really, at the moment. Obviously, the main goal is to end up on the pro tour, but as it comes on for the youth tour, want to be in the World Youth Finals at the end of the year, and then for the Challenge Tour, just see what I can do until the end of the year, and then go to Key School next year.
Yeah.
And then see what that brings, and then go from there again.
Was you at Key School last year? Sorry,
I was. Yeah,
you was. How did
you go before?
Yeah.
The first year I went and done a lot better. This year it's a bit hit and miss, a bit inconsistent more than anything, but that's all learning.
Do you feel a lot of pressure, when going to Q School, trying to, obviously, because getting your tour card's everything, isn't it?
Yeah, obviously you've got to have pressure on you. You've got people that are backing you, people that are supporting you. Obviously, you don't want to make yourself look silly, but again, it's on 4 days, anything can happen.
Of course it is, yeah.
Go on a run, brilliant, or you can have a bad week, then do well on the Challenge Tour, Youth Tour, and get it that way. You can't give up on just on one bad week or bad weekend. Can't never give up.
No, you just have to move on. Otherwise, like I said, like Darren spoke to us earlier, there's so much of it, but it's all mental, isn't it? It's getting your mind right. It's no good, playing bad and losing, say, 5-4 and then blame yourself. You just got to put it behind you, make sure you put it right and go again.
No, like I say, you've got so many tournaments nowadays, you can't just dwell on one. You know, if you're practicing well, you're mentally well and everything's going all right for you, that sooner or later it's going to come for you, and then when it does, you have to go with it. But as well, you have to roll with the punches, and
of course,
if it goes bad, just take it on the chin, go again, work harder, practice harder, and then prepare better.
A lot of dedication and sacrifices, but again, it's if you believe you can do it, which you clearly can, then you're going to reap the rewards at a later date, aren't you?
Yeah, you will. You get out of it what you put into
exactly.
It. So if you're willing to put in the work now, and then the rewards will come sooner or later. It's just, again, rolling with it.
Exactly. What about practice? Do you practice a lot?
Practice, pretty much every week with Darren. 2-3 hours, which, again, has helped me no end. Couldn't ask for a better person behind me at the moment, so I'd say
every night. That's Darren. So what about in the every night in the practice routine? What do you do? Do you tend to play legs? Do you do checkouts? Do you do what is it you practice on most?
Never played leg against him other than tournament, but all we're doing is checkouts, and which is obviously good money maker really.
Your
gains makes you money, and scoring just to loosen your arm up, because once you're scoring there, so. Like I say, what wins you the money is obviously
finishing. Of course, it's scores for show, doubles for doubles, Bobby
Jordan.
I bet this has seen a few 180s, isn't it?
Fair few.
Loads and loads. Well, massive thank you for chatting with us on Darts Planet TV today. Really appreciate it.
Not a problem.
Wish you all the best. I'd like to get along and see you at one of the Challenge Tours some point. So a massive thank you for Jack coming on the channel. If you did like it, please, as always, hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to turn the notifications on. And we'll catch you next time. Bye.